So this topic is tax invoice, credit and debit notes. So what is invoices? Under the GST regime, an invoice or tax invoice means the tax invoice referred to in section 31 of the CGST Act 2017. The section mandates issuance of invoice or a bill of supply for every supply of goods or services. An invoice or a bill of supply need not be issued if the value of the supply is less than rupees mentioned in the GST Acts. So also having notes. What are the note means? Credit and debit notes. The GST takes care of credit notes as well, just like a debit notes. Credit notes have to be issued by a taxable person where there is a shortage of products supplied and for which there is no payment to be made by the purchaser. The credit note has to be issued based on an original invoices already issued. Also, the payment of tax under GST, the tax to be paid is mainly divided into three: IGST, CGST and SCST. So IGST to be paid when interstate supply is made. So CGST when making supply within the state, and SGST making supply within the state. So these all are the tax. And tax deduct at source, like as TDS. TDS at 2% is required to be deducted on payment made to the supplier of taxable goods or services of both where the value of such supply under a contract exceed rupees 2.5 lakhs. The provisions of TDS on GST are applicable from 1st October 2008. So these are the topic cover this type of invoices. So what are the invoices? Credit and debit notes, payment of tax, and which one is TDS, and what are the purpose they are deducted with the TDS, that is called the topic of the invoices. The tax invoice under the section of 31 of GST, the provisions of section 31 to section 34 shall come into force 1/7/2017 of tax invoices. So who can issue a tax invoice under GST? Before that, we are clearly known about these type of persons for the GST invoices for issuing. As per section 31 subsection 1, a registered person supplying taxable goods shall before of at the time of removal of goods for supply to the recipient where the supply involves the movement of goods or delivery of goods or making available thereof to the recipient in any other case issue a tax invoice showing the description, quantity and value of goods, the tax charged thereon and such other particulars as may be prescribed. The government may, on the recommendation of the council, by notification specify the categories of goods or supplies in respect of which a tax invoice shall be issued within such time and in such manner as may be prescribed. The taxable services shall before or after the provision of services but within the prescribed period issue a tax invoice showing the description, the tax charged thereon and such other particulars as may be prescribed. That is under the section of 31 subsection 2. Also, the government may, on recommendation of council, by notification, specify the categories of goods, services in respect of which there are two types. Any other document issued in relation to the supply shall be deemed to be a tax invoice. A tax invoice may not be issued. There are two parts of the government may recommend. And the term of removal in relation to goods means, as per section 2, subsection 96, removal in relation to goods means dispatch of the goods for delivery by the supplier thereof by any other persons acting on behalf of such supplier, or collection of the goods by the recipient thereof, or by any other person acting on behalf of such a recipient. These all are the included for the tax invoices. And also, having some other supply of goods, tax invoices, and credit and debit notes rules. The chapter 6th one mentioned the CGST is rule of CGST of tax invoices. The rule 46 of CGST tax invoice is content of tax invoice. The subject to rule 54, a tax invoice referred to in section 31 shall be issued by the registered person containing the following particulars. What are the items included in the tax invoices? Before that, we are seeing some other bill of the or description of the product. Can I buy one book from bookshop? They can issue the bill or invoices to me. What are the contents included in the bill means, who is the seller, who is the buyer, address of the receiver, address of the sellers, and invoice numbers, description of products, how many items included, what are the rates, how much, including tax, authorization signatures and a seal, if credit or any other instruction means having some other rule and regulations. These simply mentioned in the bill. And also tax invoices having some other the particulars. The main particulars is name and address of GSTN of the suppliers. The bill or invoice having name, address and GSTN number. The GSTN number is a very, very important of the GST registrations. You are after the registration, you can get the type of number is GSTN numbers. The consecutive serial number not exceeding 16 characters of these numbers. In one or multiple series containing alphabets or numericals or special characters, hyphen or dash and slash symbols as underscore, as slash respectively, and any combination thereof unique for a financial year, that is included in the GSTN numbers. And date of its issue, name, address and GST or UIN if registered of the recipient, and name and address of the recipient and the address of delivery along with the name of state and its code if such recipient is unregistered where the value of taxable supply is 50,000 or more. At the time they are mentioned the state of the destinations. Next one, name and address of the recipient and the address of delivery along with the name of the state and its code. So it's a less than rupees 50,000 and the recipient received. And next item is HSN code of the goods and services and description of goods or services and quantity in case of goods and unit or unique quantity code thereof. Total value of supply of goods, taxable value of supply of goods, rate of tax. This is central tax or state tax or union territory tax, which is mentioned in the invoices. Amount of tax charged, place of supply, address of delivery, whether the tax is payable on reverse charge basis, and signature or digital signature of the supplier or his authorized reference status. These all are the important items along with the invoices. It is must present in the invoices. That is very, very important of invoices. Under Rule 47 of CGST mentioned the time limit for issuing of tax issues. The invoice referred to in Rule 46, in case of taxable supply of services, shall be issued within a period of 30 days from the date of supply of services. Rule 48 of CGST Rules 2017, manner of issuing invoice. The manner of issuing invoice is the original copy being marked as a original for recipient, the duplicate copy being marked as a duplicate for transporter, and the triplicate copy being marked as a triplicate for suppliers. The invoice shall be prepared in duplicate in case of supply of service in the following manner. The original copy is mentioned the original for recipient, and duplicate copy mentioned the duplicate for supplier. These all are the informed GSTR 1. So these all are the manner of issuing invoice. It is mentioned in the under the rule of 48. Next one is bill of supply. The rule 49 mentioned the bill of supply is GST number, GST EN number, HS number, description. These all are the mentioned in the bill of supply. And the receipt vouchers. The Rule 50 of CGST mentioned the receipt vouchers. Rule 51 of CGST mentioned the refund voucher. If I have any refund, the voucher mentioned in the Rule 51. And Rule 52 of CGST mentioned the payment vouchers. The Rule 53 of CGST mentioned the revised tax invoice and credit or debit notes. It is very, very important of what is the credit and what is the debit notes. The word revised invoice is, wherever applicable, indicated prominently. The name, address of GST, nature of the documents, consecutive of serial number, date of issue of the document, name and address of GST, serial number. So also every registered person who has been granted registration with effect from a date of earlier. So these all are the things in Rule 53. And Rule 54 mentioned the tax invoice in any special cases. So for example, where the supplier taxable services, insurer or banking company or financial institutions, goods transport agency, supplying passenger transportation services, these types of activities and rules mentioned in the Rule 54. And the last of Rule 55 is transportation of goods without issuing of invoices. For the purpose of supply of liquid gas, transportation of goods for job work, transportation of goods for reason other than by way of supply. So on the GST numbers, it will be a 16 characters. So consignee, original for consignee, duplicate for transporter, triplicate for consignors. These are the types of invoice mentioned, the copies. So these types of copies mentioned in the Rule 55 of CGST. The credit and debit notes, Section 34 mentioned the where a tax invoice has been issued for supply of any goods or services or both on the taxable value of tax charged in the tax invoice is found to exceed the taxable value or tax payable in respect of such supply, or where the goods supplied are returned by the recipient, where service supplied are found to be a deficient. The registered person who has supplied such goods or services, or both, may issue to recipient a credit note containing such particular as may be prescribed in the credit notes. Where to declare the details of credit note issued? Section 34, subsection 2, any registered person who issue a credit note in relation to a supply of goods or services, or both, shall declare the details of such credits in the return for the month during which such credit note has been issued, but not later than September following the end of financial year in which such supply was made, or the date of filing of the relevant annual return, whichever is earlier, and the tax liability shall be adjusted such manner as may be prescribed. So that is credit notes issued. And where to declare the details of debit note issued? The section 34 subsection 4 mentioned any registered person who issue a debit note in relation to a supply of goods and services shall declare the details of such debit note in the return for the month during which such debit note has been issued, and the tax liable shall be adjusted in such a manner as may be prescribed in the debit note. Next one, payment of tax. The provision of section 49 to section 53 except section 51 and 52 shall come into force of 2017 GST Acts. What are the main features of GST payment process is, the payment process under GST Acts have the following features. Electronically generated challan form GSTN common portal in all modes of payment and no use of manually prepared challan. Next, facilitations for the taxpayer by providing hassle-free anytime, anywhere mode of payment of tax, and convenience of making payment online, and logical tax collection date in electronic forms, and faster remittance of tax revenue to the government account, paperless transactions, speedy accounting and reporting, electronic reconciliation of all receipts, simplified procedure for banks, warehousing of digital challan. These all are the process for the mentioned in the payment of tax under the section of 49 to 53. And payment of tax, interest, penalty and other amounts mentioned in the section 49 detailed. Every deposit made towards tax, interest, penalty, fee or any other amount by a person by internet banking or by using credit or debit cards or national electronics fund transfer or real-time cross settlement or by such other mode and subject to such conditions and restriction as may be prescribed shall be credited to the electronic cash ledgers. Such person to be maintained in such manner as may be prescribed in section 49 subsection 1. These types of mode of payment is mentioned in the payment of tax. The input tax credit as self-assessed in the return of registered person shall be credited to his electronic credit ledgers. The date of credit to the account of the appropriate government in the authorized bank shall be deemed to the date of deposit. These all are the mainly mentioned in the payment of tax. And also electronic cash ledger shall be used. Electronic credit ledger shall be used. And e-cash credit ledger be utilized. And incident of tax. And discharge of persons. And delayed payment of GST. under by supplier of GST. So these all are things having in the payment of tax. Next one is types of ledgers. So what are e-ledgers? The e-ledger is electronic ledger or e-ledgers or statement of cash and input tax credit in respect of each registered taxpayers. In addition, each taxpayer shall also have an electronic tax liability register. This is called as a e-registers. So what is the tax liability register? Tax liability register will reflect the total tax liability of taxpayer for the particular month. So what is cash ledgers? The cash ledger will reflect all deposit made in cash and TDS, TCS made on account of the taxpayer. So what is an ITC ledger? The input tax credit as self-assessed in monthly returns will be reflected in the ITC ledgers. So these all are the related to the types of ledgers. So what are the types of ledger is ITC ledgers, cash ledgers and the e-ledgers. So payment challan, what is payment challan? Can a taxpayer generate challan in multiple sitting? Yes. A taxpayer can partially fill in the challan form and temporarily save the challan form completion at a later stage. A saved challan can be edited before finalizations. And also this challan generator online be modified. What are the validity period of challan mentioned? And what is a CPIN? The CPIN is Common Portal Identification Number given at the time of generation of challan. It is a 14-digit unique number to identify the challan. As stated above, the CPIN remain valid for a period of 15 days. The payment challan mentioned the number. And also TDS, Tax Direct at Source, Section 51 mentioned the TDS. And EFBP, EFBP stands for the Electronic Focal Point Branch. And nature of payments, rate of TDS, what are the conditions of no TDS, and deposit to the government of TDS, and cash ledgers, refund TDS, these all are the mentioned the topic of TDS. So apart from the TDS, one more thing is tax collected at source, that is called as a TCS. Who is liable to collect tax at source under GST? The TDS already we have studied in the UG level. The tax collected source is mentioned in section 52 of GST is nature of payments. Every electronic commerce operator hereafter in this section referred to as the operators, not being an agent, shall collect the amount of calculated rate of tax, net value of taxable supplies. These all are the mentioned in the tax collected at source under the section of 52. When shall such TCS be deposited with the government? Section 52 subsection 3, the amount collected under section 52 subsection 1 shall be paid to the government by the operator within 10 days after the end of the month in which such collection is made in such manner as may be prescribed in the TCS. How a supplier shall claim credit of TCS? The supplier who has supplied the goods or services or both through the operator shall claim credit in his electronic cash ledgers. Already mentioned and discussed about the electronic cash ledgers. What is the electronic cash ledgers? Now we are very vast playing of the electronic cash ledgers in GST. And what is the obligation of every operator with respect to details of statement furnished. This section 52(8) mentions the details of supplies furnished by the every operator under subsection 4 shall be matched with the corresponding details of outward supplies. And what are the TCS with outward supplies and the rectified of the supplies? These are the mentions under the TCS. And also transfer of input tax credit. This section 53 mentions GST. What is the procedure for transfer of input tax credits? And utilization of input tax credits availed under this act for payment of tax dues under the Integrated Goods and Service Tax Act in accordance with the provisions of section 49, subsection 5. So also, what are the rules for paying the payment of tax is Rule 85 is electronic liability registered, and Rule 86 is electronic credit ledgers, and Rule 87 is electronic cash ledgers, and Rule 88 of the CGST Rules 2017 is identification number for each transactions. A unique identification number shall be generated at the common portal for each debit or credit to the electronic cash or credit ledger, as the case may be. The unique identification number relating to discharge of any liability shall be indicated in the corresponding cases in the electronic liability registered. A unique identification number shall be generated at the common portal for each credit in the electronic liability registered for reason other than those covered under the sub rules. These are the topic covered under the invoices. So we go through about the what are the topics we covered in this chapter is invoices. What are the concept of invoices or bills? How many copies are prepared? And what is the credit and debit notes? So what are the rules mentioned in the credit and debit notes? Rule 108 and Rule 109 mentioned in the credit note and debit notes. And third one is part of the payment of tax. And what are the rules of payment of tax mentioned in the section 52 subsection 6 and section 52 subsection 8, some other mentioned in the payment of tax. And the last one is TDS. What is TDS? Not only TDS, and what are the TCS? So these all are the items in the payment of tax.